Wind, rain, powerful currents, hazardous terrain, low visibility, unstable air. These are all known obstacles that rescue helicopter teams face daily. The gloves used to protect the hands of first responders guiding hoist rescue cables should not be one of these obstacles, and yet they are. In 2017, a first responder from San Diego Fire and Rescue brought it to the attention of the U.S. Department of Homeland Security Science and Technology Directorate that there was a capability gap as far as rescue hoist gloves were concerned. Hoist operators were going through their current gloves after two or three rescue missions, causing damage to their hands and leaving frayed material in the hoist machinery.
So he wanted to look at a glove that would provide adequate protection as well as durability, allow for dexterity as well as tactility for the hoist rescue operator.
I think this assessment is important because you really want to get the best out of the product we're going to use. We've basically been using leather gloves for the last 20 years and obviously they're not up to standard compared to what we just use now.
The purpose of today's operational field assessment is to have hoist glove operators evaluate two prototype gloves that are supposed to increase longevity and dexterity.
The Coast Guard's Aviation Technical Training Center in Elizabeth City, North Carolina, provided the perfect location for the operational field assessment. Within the facility, first responders, serving as evaluators, assessed the dexterity and longevity of the prototype gloves by attempting water rescue scenarios as powerful wind and rain machines simulated hazardous weather conditions. The evaluators guided steel cable hoists, manipulated controls, operated radios, and slid across helicopter floors to challenge the gloves in real-world scenarios.
The field assessment is important to make sure that we have the proper glove for the job that we do. You don't want to be hindered by the equipment that you're using when you're out on a search and rescue case, and so it's important to make sure that we have the best equipment possible for our flight mechanics in the field.
So now that the operational field assessment is complete, we will take back the data, analyze it, and identify trends for the prototype gloves and compare them to the commercial off-the-shelf products.
And to provide the project performer constructive criticism on how to improve those gloves before they go to commercialization.
The hands that guide the rescue hoist cable are just as important as the cable and basket. An enhanced hoist rescue glove will protect the hands that help save lives.